The Prime Minister has farewelled troops heading for Afghanistan as more than 1,300 were welcomed home at a parade in Townsville. The Chief of Defence joined the Prime Minister, paying tribute to fallen friends who didn't make it back.
Welcome homes don't get much better than this.
It's always special to be back with the family, be back with the kids.
As more than 1,000 troops marched down Townsville's Esplanade, their family, friends and Australia's Chief of Defence welcomed them home. Most of these men and women have spent the best part of a year serving in the Middle East, mentoring the Afghan National Army. After 8 months away, these soldiers are looking forward to spending some quality time back with their family and friends. But sadly, 11 soldiers didn't come home last year. And today, these troops remember their fallen mates. But instead of a minute's silence...
I want us to remember those who fell through acclamation.
These are men and women who have served the nation in harm's way, who've returned home. But they've seen mates who have been hurt, wounded, and in some instances, they've seen good mates killed.
Earlier, the Prime Minister was in town for morning tea with troops who will soon head to Afghanistan. She's still committed to withdrawing from the war zone in 2014.
We've been in Afghanistan a long time. It's cost us a lot as a nation. There have been some days of incredible sorrow.
In Townsville, Melissa Vanderhaak, 10 News.
Well, after some mechanical issues with the Prime Minister's VIP plane, Julia Gillard is finally en route to Chicago for a major NATO summit.
Political reporter Leah Craven joins us now with the details from Canberra. Leah, the Prime Minister will arrive a little later than planned, but will she miss anything?
No, this won't be too disruptive to her plans, which is fortunate because this is a vital meeting on Afghanistan. World leaders will be discussing the strategy to start pulling troops out of Afghanistan and talk about how the international community can support the Afghan army once all foreign troops are gone for good, which is scheduled at the moment for the end of 2014. Now, the price tag to sustain a local army there is put at $4 billion, and it's not going to be easy to raise this money because most of the countries involved in this war are facing some very serious fiscal pressures back home. But Australia's already said how much money we're willing to contribute. Julia Gillard's offered $100 million a year for 3 years after Australian troops go home.
We don't want that progress lost, which is why it's vital that the world community appropriately sustains Afghan forces beyond the days of transition.
Now, one of the fresh faces at the summit, France's new president, François Hollande, has already ruffled a few feathers. He's said that his troops will be coming home much earlier than planned. Not everyone's happy about this, but Julia Gillard said this won't affect Australia's plans at all.
And Leah, the real battleground for Julia Gillard appears to be on the home front. Another diabolical poll out today.
A Galaxy poll has been published today, and this has surveyed voters in Queensland about federal Labor, and it's found its primary vote is at a dismal 23%. And this is a 10-point slump from the 2010 federal election. Now, if there was an election to be held soon and things didn't improve for Labor, this could mean a virtual wipeout for lower house MPs. And some of these MPs are very high-profile people like Kevin Rudd and Wayne Swan.
Leah Craven reporting there from Parliament House in Canberra. Thank you.